I think he supports the airstrikes, and I think it's very important. You know, this is a dangerous, barbaric death cult that we've got here. We have to deal with it. I think in the past, UKIP's position has very much been that we shouldn't get involved in foreign wars, and we absolutely stick to that 100%. But this is something now that is affecting British people. We've got jihadists from Britain going out there. We've got English hostages, British hostages that are being killed. We have to do some kind of action.
He said today he wouldn't vote to support these airstrikes in Parliament today.
Well, I think
he said that repeatedly this morning, yeah. So he doesn't support the airstrikes.
Well, I think, okay, fine, I perhaps haven't caught up with that, but I think the interesting thing is that there is a question to be asked about why Britain is actually participating in this. America is there, we've got the five other Arab nations as well that are taking part in this. Is British intervention really necessary?
What the Prime Minister says is right, isn't it? If UKIP do well in the general election, that will let Labour in.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter, does it? David Cameron comes up with this guff about a referendum.
Well, you don't believe he would deliver a referendum?
No, I don't believe he'll deliver it. Dan Hannan, who's still in the Conservative Party, doesn't believe it. Douglas Carswell doesn't believe it.
Dan Hannan does believe that he'll deliver a referendum.
Well, he might hold a referendum, Michael, but what sort of a referendum will it be? It will be a bogus kind of renegotiation like we had in 1975.
Well, then you can campaign to come out.
Yeah, absolutely. But
you won't get that if Tom's party wins.
Oh, I think we will. And actually, I think...
Will he, Tom? Well, let's
know. Ed has set himself against it.
But there you go, you won't get one.
Politics deployed. I mean, he's
What's your problem?
Don't you think we can push and push and push, Tom?
But sorry, back
I think
to,
we might
back
just be able to push
to
you
logic,
into it.
Back Michael? To the logic of your position. You believe that it doesn't make any difference to you having a Tory government because although there will be a referendum, somehow the negotiation will have been fixed. What difference does that make to the referendum?
Well, I think it makes a huge difference to the referendum because what happened in 1975, it was all fixed. We were told by, you know, there was this huge renegotiation. We got significant...
The renegotiation was fixed. Of course it was, but the vote wasn't fixed. People could have voted for or against the European Union.
Yeah, but look
if
at
there
the
is
huge...
a vote, if there is a vote in future, it doesn't matter whether the negotiation's being fixed, the vote will be free. You're not saying that the vote's going to be rigged,
went into the campaign to stay in, and a fraction of those resources
went into
the campaign to stay out. It was completely unfair. It was fixed from the start, and I'm afraid it would be the same again.
But your position then is you don't want to vote because you don't think you're going to win.
Well, of course we want a referendum, of course, and we will push very, very hard for it. But I mean, David Cameron, is he going to even get that majority government? There are so many caveats.
That is a different question. You might stop
him. So many caveats.
Do you agree with your leader that the Prime Minister recalling Parliament for a debate tomorrow is a cynical ploy to steal the limelight from your conference?
I'm afraid I do. I think I've been in politics long enough now to know that you have to be a little bit cynical, I'm afraid.
So the forefront of his mind, Suzanne, surely that's the key. Surely an important debate on Britain joining airstrikes against, as you say, barbaric people in IS is really more important than anything else at the moment, whenever he decided to recall Parliament.
Indeed, I totally agree, Joe.